Hello viewers, today we are going to see how to install Twister OS in Raspberry Pi 4. So let's get into the installation process. So on the step 1, download Twister OS. So go to raspbianx.com and hit the download button over there and choose the folder and download it. So let it download. Before that, let's see what is Twister OS. So Twister OS is an amazing OS developed by PyLab. So PyLab is an amazing thing. They make many OS for Raspberry Pi. It is a mixture of two OS. One is a Windows themed OS and other is a Mac OS X themed OS. So this has some interesting features. So in the desktop, there will be an icon. When you hit it, it will switch the OS to the Mac OS or Windows, vice versa. So now let's see the downloading process. So over here you can see that the OS has been successfully downloaded. So let's get to the step 2. So on the step 2, we have to download and install Balina HR. So this is in software to flash the ROM into our SD card. So hit that arrow and choose your OS. In my case, it is Windows. So when I click Windows, it will redirect to the site and it will ask me to download. Choose the folder and click download. So it is downloading. Now let's see what is the Balina HR. So this tool helps to flash the ROM which we have installed, that which are Twister OS, into the SD card. So it is like an bootable drive, to create a bootable drive for the Raspberry Pi OS. So now let's wait for the software to download. After the download has completed, go to the path where you have downloaded, click the app installation thing and click agree, and let's wait for it to install. It will install within 10 to 15 seconds. So now it has been successfully installed. And now it will open the Balina HR tool itself. Now you need a 16 GB is recommended SD card and plug it inside an USB adapter for the computer. And next thing is you have to plug in the USB adapter to your computer. So when you plug in the USB inside the computer, in the desktop you can see a message that it has been connected successfully. So the next step is also simple. Just search the software. So the Balina HR, and click flash from file and select the file. And next over here, if you have inserted only one SD card to the computer, it will be automatically chosen. So if you have one pen drive and the SD card plugged in, just check whether the drive is SD card. And next thing is you just have to click flash. So this may take a while. So let's wait for it. So it has successfully completed flashing it, and it will show up this message. You need to format this drive and drive hatch before you can use it. Do not format it, just click cancel. So now let's just go to disk manager and let me show you. So yeah, it is not properly detected by the computer over here. So now the flash is completed. Let's go to the next step. So the next step is simple. You just have to unplug the SD card from the computer and just remove the SD card from the USB adapter. So the next thing is gonna be super simple. You need a Raspberry Pi 3 or 3B plus or 4. So I have a Raspberry Pi 4 version over here, and this is an optional thing, and cooling fan with a heat sink. This is optional, just for cooling purpose. So I have used this, and also the SD card which here flashes over here. And you also need a setup like a keyboard, monitor and mouse. So let me show you my setup. Over here I have my USB keyboard. Over here I have my USB mouse. And also my monitor over here.
So now let's go into the process. Just insert the SD card at the SD card slot over here. Just keep it over here. And also, I forgot to mention that if you are using Raspberry Pi 4, you need a special micro HDMI cable to an HDMI cable adapter for your monitor. So because over here minus and micro HDMI and my monitor, it supports only HDMI. So I have already connected the one end of my HDMI cable to my monitor. So on the other end is over here. So you can see I have already connected it to the monitor. So the other end we just have to connect it in the HDMI 0. You can connect dual display also. So this is the HDMI 0. Yeah, I have connected it. Let me keep it over here. So the next is the mouse and keyboard. Let me move the keyboard back and the Raspberry Pi front. So over here I have my Raspberry Pi and the keyboard is over here. Just connect the keyboard to it. And also the mouse. My mouse is towards the. Let me connect it. So Raspberry Pi 4 has USB 3.0. And the next thing is an Type-C cable. So Raspberry Pi 4 is powered with an Type-C cable. So I have my Type-C cable and I have my power bank over here. You can also use an 5 volt wall adapter. And let me connect it. So the other end I have not connected to the power bank yet. So yeah, that's it. Now let me just show you the setup. So you can clearly see the setup over here. Let me just focus on the monitor. So now I'm gonna power the power bank. Raspberry Pi using the power bank. Let me plug in. So yeah, we can see the sign over here. The LEDs are on. Over here, yes, you can see it is gonna boot. Yeah, it is booting. So it is success until now. Let's wait for it to boot. So guys, now it has successfully booted. It looks like a Windows 10, but it is not. It is the Raspberry Pi, the OS. Let's open it. Where the password is Raspberry. Yeah, it looks exactly like Windows. So over here you can see the file manager, which looks like Windows. And also over here, instead of Windows icon, there is an Pi icon, Raspberry icon. So here, it also has a stream support and also ETA Prime Channel showed that it also has support to Netflix. So that's super cool. So it is detecting this like a laptop. Okay, Chrome is also working properly. So let me try to connect to Wi-Fi. So yeah, the Pi also support 5 GHz Wi-Fi. I'm just connecting the Pi 5 GHz Wi-Fi. So over here you could see it is connecting to Wi-Fi and the animations are super cool. And the best part is let's wait for the Wi-Fi to connect. After that, let me show you the best part of it. So over here the Wi-Fi has been successfully connected. Let me show you. Yeah, over here. And also you can see that this side of it. So it looks like a Raspberry logo over here. And yeah, the interesting thing is over here. So I think many of you has noticed this. So switch to iRaspbian. And also it also has command by which you can also do something like overclocking etc. And also it has some cool features. Let me come back to it later. So yeah, over here you can see the command pi. Now let's test the switch to Mac OS iRaspbian. Let's open it. And yeah, it is we have to just press enter. and let's see how much time it takes to open the different OS. So I think it is switching the UI faster. So even now it doesn't took much time. Now it's exactly like a Mac OS. So I think over here also password should be Raspberry. Raspberry. Yeah, that's the correct password. So yeah, and music has been played. So even while I'm using logging in the Windows, the same music has played. So it's exactly like Mac over here. Let me show you. Yeah. Over here, instead of an Apple logo, there is a Raspberry logo. So that's so cool. It's same like in Mac OS. Even the icons are similar. Let me show you. So over here, you can see the icons are also similar. So instead of the Finder, here it is a Tuner File Manager. So it's different, and also the icons are just same. Not the app itself. Yeah, there are some changes because they cannot bring the absolute Mac OS to here. So the thing is, there is RetroPie in this. That is super cool. If you have a gamepad connected to a USB gamepad or Bluetooth gamepad, you can use that to play some retro games. So, and also there are some other cool things in it. Let's see one by one. In the app launcher, in the iRaspberry and Mac OS themed thing, you could just there are many interesting apps over here. Let me just show you. Yeah, there are many interesting apps. There is something to unzip PDF viewer. I think this is Adobe AutoCAD, and also LibreOffice. So even in Linux, they use LibreOffice because it's less like an open source thing. So it is just like an alternative to Microsoft Office. Let's just this. So yeah, LibreOffice Draw is like MS Paint, but something like an advanced version of it. Let's close it and just see some other app. There is also something like a sensor view over here, and also so there are many apps over here. Terminal, stream. So you could just also play games in stream. So that's super cool. Let me quickly switch to Windows thing. Now it will just switch on to Windows. Let me come back after I came to Windows. So here you can see I just came to the Windows. So here you can see it. There are some Windows as of Microsoft Office logos over here. When I click it, it opens the LibreOffice. Same like the thing which we have saw in Mac themed thing. The icons are same, but the thing is different. And also, it also has something like generic Python IDL and many things like that. So everything is over here, terminal, web browser, everything. So it's so cool. And also I have just read the readme file, and I found one thing over here. You can see that requirements is Raspberry Pi 4, so it doesn't works on Raspberry Pi 3, but there is a way which you can make to work on Raspberry Pi 3. So that even they have given over here, Raspberry Pi 3 will boot, but you may need to enable. So it will boot properly, but you need to enable the GL driver from the Raspberry Pi config file, which is in the boot folder of the SD card. So you can just Google it and just do, but even though it will boot. So you cannot get a seamless experience like in Raspberry Pi 4 in a Raspberry Pi 3. So let's just see the shutdown. So yeah, it just shutdowns normally.
So that's it for today. Please do like, share and subscribe to this video.